Hello, everyone. My name is Chad Smith, and welcome to part 3 of our Simplicity Alarming series, where we will be discussing alarm classes, or how to change the appearance of the alarms in Simplicity. So to begin, we'll start by showing the defaults. You can see an alarm viewer here with the default colors of alarms when you first install Simplicity. And those correspond to alarm classes. By default, we have a high, low, medium, and system class, all of which are initially set to the same colors. So you can see in the alarm class configuration that you can set up the different states to be different colors. So you can set up the normal and unavailable state to have its own colors and blinking scheme. You can set up the different alarm levels to have different colors and blinking. And the acknowledge state as well can be configured separately. You also have the ability to set the order of the alarm class such that if you sort your alarm viewer by class order, it will respect the order that you set in each class. So what we're going to do today is we're going to change one of these alarms appearance using classes. So to do that, I'll just start by showing again, putting something into alarm like this. So you can see right now our temperature point is using the same alarm class as everything else. So if I want to change that, I can go into my point in my points database, go to the temperature, and you can see under the alarm tab, you can set the alarm class for any given point that has an alarm in it. So I'm going to change our alarm class to alarm demo, or to the demo class. And I'll show you that here in the alarm classes. I've created a slightly different setup for this class to show alarms in a different way. So you can see that the normal state has a foreground color of green, background white, and etc. All these alarm states have slightly different than the default. So I'll just show you, so you can see that when I applied this demo state to the temperature, it immediately shifted the alarm appearance because I'm in dynamic mode in Simplicity. So that alarm class change took effect immediately, and because it is in alarm, you can see that its foreground is black and its background color is rose. If I bring that alarm back into a normal state but not yet acknowledged, you can again see that it goes into the acknowledged state where its foreground is green, its background is white. Again, if I were to acknowledge that alarm, it would go away. And if I put it into an alarm again, it would respect that alarm class. So let's make one other small change. Let's say that if we go into a high, high state, we want to actually have it blink at 3/4 of a second or so. So I'm going to say that when it's in high, high state, it's going to have a red foreground color and a white background color. So if you want to immediately apply all these settings to all of the alarm levels, you can hit this button and it'll apply it to all of them. It's a little speed up button for you to use. So I'm going to apply that. And now I'm going to change the temperature into a high, high state of 38 degrees. You can see when it's in a high, high state, it's blinking according to that alarm class setting. If I bring it back down into another alarm state, but still an alarm, but not high, high, it goes to the high state. So there's just a quick introduction to alarm classes in Simplicity. We'll see more about alarm classes as they apply to alarm setups or filters in another video. Thanks for watching.